All praises to the Most High God of Israel. It's our midweek teaching. It's a blessing to be before the holiest people on the face of the earth. Well, let's just say the holy people, because there's nobody else holy but Israel. It's an honor to come before you and bring a word from the Most High God. I am V.E. Smith, and I am the Rib of the Watchman. And tonight's teaching is going to be about a thing that a lot of people are kind of confused on. And you get confused with everything that God ever taught Israel. There's a confusion out there about it because Lucifer came on the scene and he took those things and he twisted them and he changed them and messed them up. Well, tonight we're going to deal with possessed. And a lot of our teachings coming up as children, we only taught the New Testament. So when we learned about possessed, we learned that it meant that evil spirits overtook you and possessed you and made you, controlled you and did things with you. Well, we are going to not go into that realm of it as far as dealing with possessed, because there is no possessed that way. But when God puts an evil spirit in you and uses you to do something evil, that's totally different from being possessed. And the watchman's going to come and he's going to continue this teaching on into more in-depth understanding over it. But I'm going to give you the basis, and I'm going to give you to get you prepared for your Sabbath teaching and understanding over the word possessed. And we're going to compare God's possessed to Lucifer's possessed, so that you can see again how things have been taken out of the context of what God was saying and how God's people knew things. And see, what we got to also understand is we were sleeping, and to a sleeping person you can pretty much do anything to them. You can tell them anything, they're paying any attention, they're not absorbing it, they're asleep. So for us, we're still Hebrew Israelites, but we were literally asleep. And all these things during our sleeping time, this downtime of knowledge, we took on all the understanding that cattle has taught us and told us about, and that's how we pretty much live our lives. So today we're going to take this time out, this midweek teaching, to give you an idea of what possessed means biblically and not Lucifer, his meaning. So we're going to start in Numbers, and we're going to go to Numbers 21. Now, I'm not going to even read the whole text of the scripture. I'm not even going to read some of them. I'm just going to read a sentence out of them, because I'm going to basically give you a rundown of what this word means in the Old Testament and what it means in the New Testament. And there are 24 verses. You know, we're not going to do all 24, because I've got a pretty big one to read you. I think it's in Proverbs or Nehemiah. It's in one of those books. But so that this video doesn't go for hours and hours, we're going to just look at the scriptures here and pull out only that needs to be pulled out dealing with the word possessed. And in Numbers 21, verse 24 says, "And Israel smote him with the edge of the sword and possessed his land." Okay, I don't need to go any further, because that's self-explanatory over the word possessed. And we're going to see if a pattern is formed here. Let's go to Numbers 21 and 25. "So they smote him and his sons and all his people until there were none left him alive, and they possessed his land." Now, before I go any further, I'm going to give you the dictionary's definition of their explaining of the word possessed. Now, this is how the word is used in the Old Testament: to have as belonging to one, have as property, own. Okay? He possessed his house and his car. That means he is the owner of it. He's the sole owner of his house and his car. So that is what I'm going to give you as we read these scriptures. So now we can put two and two together about where we're going with possessed. Now, before I go any further, I'll let you bring into this so that your thinking can be swayed on this too while we're learning. everything you know about possessed is pretty much the Lucifer way. Because if someone says, "Oh, that boy was possessed," the first thing you think about, you don't think about, well, who owns him? You would never say, "Oh, he's possessed. Who owns him?" You would say, "Oh, what devil's in him? What demon's in him? Oh, what?" That's not what possessed means in this Old Testament. And we're going to keep on going, and we're going to keep on reading so that you can kind of get an understanding of where your thinking was and where your thinking is today on words that we read every day in the Bible, but we don't understand what we're reading. And see, this is the confusion of starting the book from the tail end and working it to the middle, to the beginning. It'll all be confusing to you. So let's go to Deuteronomy 3 and 12. Like I said, it's a lot of these, and I want to try to run through the majority of them so that you can get a foundation for what we're talking about. And this land, which we possessed at that time, this land, all right, that's all we need. You don't need to go any further because we know we're talking about land is what is being possessed, meaning taking ownership of. Okay, let's go down here to Deuteronomy 4:47. And they possessed his land. They didn't go in there and say, "We possess this land." And no. See, y'all got too much Hollywood in you. You got too much of that theater stuff in you. That stuff that cattle has taught you about the words. It means possess. Things around here like a phone. I possess this phone. I own this cell phone. That's my phone. So that phone's possessed. It belongs to me. I have ownership of it. That's what possessed means. Let's go to Deuteronomy 30:5. And the Lord thy God will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possessed. That means your fathers owned it. They were the sole possessors of this land. They possessed the land. See the pattern that's forming, Israel? Have I not yet gotten to any verses where the people were, and people can be possessed because they can be owned? Over here, when God turned things upside down, cattle believed they owned Israel. They believed they owned God's holy people. So they were the sole possessors of them. See? So it was, we wouldn't walk around like zombies, we're possessed, we're... No, they just owned you in their mindset, in the way they thought. Let's go to Joshua 1:15. Now, also understand, spirits and possessed do not go together. The watchman is going to teach you about spirits. Because God has many spirits. God's got evil spirits. God's got lying spirits. God's got... But God will put them on you. He'll put them in you. He'll use them on you and in you and with you. But when you own something, that's possessed. Now Joshua 1:15. Until the Lord have given ye your brethren rest, as he hath given you, and they also have possessed the land which the Lord your God giveth them. Y'all, do I really need to keep going? But I will. We got Joshua. Let's see what Joshua 12:1 has to say. Now, these are the kings of the land which the children of Israel smote, and possessed their land on the other side, Jordan toward the rising of the sun. Huh? That's Joshua 13:1. We can come down to the middle of the reading where it says, thou art old and stricken in years, and there remaineth yet very much land to be possessed. Okay. Now, you can read some of these other ones because there's a bunch of them. And basically, they're all dealing with land. But there's a couple of them that's dealing with something else. And we're going to take a look at that. Let's go to Nehemiah. Let's look at Nehemiah 9 and 25. And they took strong cities and a fat land. There's land again. And possessed houses full of all goods. Now, y'all know that in your Christian thinking and the way that you have been thinking, you would think the houses were possessed. Because y'all watched so much Twilight Zone and so much that you think, oh, the ghost of somebody lives in that house. I'm not buying that house. Somebody died in there and their spirit's still in there. Oh, God, God, God. That's the way your thinking would go. Because in your mindset, you're thinking possessed means full of evil spirits. And no, possessed the houses full of all goods. Wells digged, vineyards, and olive yards, and fruit trees in abundance. So they did eat, and were filled, and became fat, and delighted themselves in thy great goodness. There ain't anything to do with ooba gooba gooba spirits. No, absolutely nothing. When you're dealing with possessed in the Old Testament, it's ownership. Taking of land, taking of goods, taking of cattle, taking of these things. If somebody has animals or somebody has something, you go in and you take it. Then you are the possessor of it. You now possessed it. Okay? But let's look at Proverbs. Now, Proverbs 8. I'm going to read from verse 1, and we're going to read down, and we're going to get an understanding of this, because, see, this is really, really, really important, because a lot of people have said, oh, this is about Jesus. Here's Jesus. Well, no, this isn't about Jesus. This is about wisdom. And we're going to learn something about wisdom tonight that you probably never thought about, but you probably knew, but because your mind goes so far off into the theatrics of it with this ooba gooba gooba crap. You know, people always tell me something, why they cussing? I don't cuss, first of all. I say foul words because I use them to express what I have to say. If you don't like them, go find somebody that don't use foul words if you think you're going to get this knowledge. Good luck. Secondly, cursings and blessings come from the Father. That bullshit that y'all say over there in the New Testament and all that heebie-jeebie crap and all that stuff, that ain't cursing. That's foolish talk. Now, you may mess your life up living by that, of course, but that's not cursing. God has blessings and cursings, and He uses them at His will. Let's read Proverbs 8. Doeth not wisdom cry? Now, most people, when this sentence starts out, would think that this is not about wisdom. But the whole chapter 8 is dealing with wisdom. It's all about wisdom and her greatness. All right? And he's going to tell you who possesses it. It was possessed in the beginning, huh? Let's see who owned it. Let's go on down here and read. And understanding put forth her voice. Huh? Wisdom can speak, y'all. And I know for a fact it does. It speaks to me all the time. She standeth in the top of high places, by the way in the places of the path. She crieth at the gate, at the entry of the city, at the coming in at the door. Unto you, O men, I cry. Ain't she something? And my voice is to the sons of men. Oh, ye simple, huh? Call ye out just like y'all. Oh, ye simple, understand wisdom. And ye fools, be ye of an understanding heart. Hear. For I will speak of excellent things, and the opening of my lips shall be right things. For my mouth shall speak truth, and wickedness is an abomination to my lips. So when wisdom comes, It ain't got nothing to do with no wickedness. It's an abomination unto her lips. All the words of my mouth are in righteousness. There is nothing forward or perverse in them. They are all plain in him that understandeth, and the right to them that find knowledge. Y'all done found knowledge and lied to me no more, .org. Huh? Y'all didn't know it was out there. Y'all didn't know that God talked to his children and explained things to them, and they can tell you, huh? Receive my instruction, and not silver, and knowledge rather than choice gold. For wisdom is better than rubies, and all the things that may be desired are not to be compared to it. Huh? Hey, you don't compare no Tesla to no wisdom in an ugly car. Ah, wisdom dwell with prudence, and find out knowledge and witty inventions. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride, and arrogancy, and the evil way, and the forward mouth do I hate. See, wisdom got a list of stuff it don't like. So if that's you, if I called you out, any of them, but you got one of them, wisdom don't handle dealing with you. Counsel is mine, and sound wisdom. I am understanding. I have strength. By me kings reign and princes decree justice. By me princes rule and nobles, even all the judges of the earth. I love them that love me, and those that seek me early shall find me. Hot dog, and y'all try to put Lucifer in the place of wisdom. Come on now, you got to know how to read, and you got to know what you're reading, and you got to be able to see it. Riches and honor are with me, yea, durable riches and righteousness. My first is better than gold. My fruit is better than gold, yea, than fine gold, and my revenue than choice silver. I lead in the way of righteousness, in the midst of the path of judgment, that I may cause those that love me to inherit substance, and I will fill their treasure. The Lord possessed me in the beginning. God owns me. God is my possessor. I'm his possession. God possessed me in the beginning of his way, before his works of old. I was set up from everlasting, from the beginning and over the earth, and ever the earth was, or ever the earth was, meaning I was there in the beginning. I was with God, huh? Not Lucifer, not your goddamn Jesus. Wisdom, she was there, possessed by God, sole ownership of wisdom. There y'all go. And y'all read, because there's a bunch more. Go and get your concordance and go look in your different books and see what wisdom belong, who wisdom belonged to, and how it was possessed by God. And when Israel went in there and possessed the land and took ownership, man, nothing to do with none of the stuff Lucifer was talking about. Because we can really look at some of this bullshit that they talk about in the New Testament dealing with possessed. Alright, let's go to Matthew 4:24. Now, we don't need to do the top part because it's stupid. It's all stupid. But I'm going to just go in the middle ways there. And it says, and those which were possessed with devils. Already right out the gate. Already before we even start. He's on a bullshit trip. Talking foolishness that you got in your spirit and you're filled with now. And your understanding is so twisted to knowledge that it makes no sense when you hear God's word. Matthew 8:16. When the even was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils. Bullshit. Not a soul that you read was possessed with devils. First of all, you got to know who devils are. Devils are just people. Devils are different people. That's a whole nation of people. Did you not know that? We'll teach you that too. But anyway, devils are people. It's a class of people. It's a group of people. Y'all done made devils be Satan. Satan has nothing to do with devils. Satan is not a devil. And y'all made a connection and made this big Hollywood theatrical thing out of a simple word as ownership. Matthew 8:28. And when he was come to the other side, into the country of the Gerasenes, or whoever that is, them met him to possess with devils. Matthew 8:33. And told everything and what was befallen to the possessed of the devils. Matthew 9:32. As they went out, behold, they brought to him a dumb man possessed with devils. Do you see the mindset that this shit tries to give you? I'm not reading all this crap. You go in there and read all this bullshit. I don't mess with this crap unless I'm here to disprove it. I don't read this crap no more than I pick up and read the Satanical Book of Foolishness. That's what this is. But I have to show you the difference between God's understanding and Lucifer, a.k.a. Jesus. All this stuff about being possessed with devils is a crock of shit. Now, if God wants to possess you and fill you with some evil spirit, he can do that because he owns you. But Israel, possessed means to own something, to have ownership of. And like I said, I'm bringing you the basics. I want your understanding to be open to receive what the Most High has given your watchman, so that you can get a total clarity over the things that you read and the things that you see in your holy word. It's real important, Israel, because a lot of things that you've been thinking that were are not. It's the total opposite. The total opposite. It's like night and day. What you think God's saying and what God is actually saying, you've got to have her wisdom to understand. So I want to thank you for tuning in. I want to thank you for listening to a word from the Most High God, from the rib of the watchman. And to be prepared and get ready and feast on this, because the watchman's coming behind me and he is going to teach you some important things, some give you some knowledge and wisdom and understanding from the Most High, that you can wash yourself of this bull crap. Get this stuff out your system. That's our problem. And see, that's where Lucifer get all this feel stuff. You feel with this and you feel with a bunch of stupid stuff they've taught you from a church. They're non-understanding, and they're believing a lie. So we're going to get those lies out of you, Israel, and we're going to get some knowledge in you, some wisdom, and some understanding. So we thank you again for tuning in. I pray that you have a wonderful, enjoyable, blessed week, and look forward to your Sabbath teaching, Israel. This has been the Rib of the Watchman. Shalom.